In this video, I'm going to show you how to use widgets in iOS using the companion app. Make sure you stick around, and if you like what you see, hit subscribe below so you don't miss out on future videos. Hi, I'm Will from Will Surridge Tech. And in this video, I'm going to show you how to use iOS widgets using the iOS companion app for Home Assistant and Node-RED. So let's get going. This is just going to be a quick video to show you a simple example and how to set up widgets in the iOS companion app. If you haven't already, check out my other video on iOS notifications. To do this, we're going to start off in the iOS companion app. We're going to go into the sidebar, scroll down, click App Configuration, scroll down again and click Actions. We click to create a new action. In here, we give it a name and a text. The name is the ID that we use to trigger it, and the text is just what we want to appear in the widget section of the phone. Once happy, we can customize it. We can change the text color, the background color, and even add an icon and color that too. If we click Save, we can leave the app and head over to Node-RED. In Node-RED, we're going to head over to the iOS tab, and then we're going to start our flow with an Events All node. This node triggers when anything happens anywhere in Home Assistant, so we're going to filter that down. We're going to add the event type as iOS.ActionFired. We're then going to need a Switch node to determine which widget has been pressed, or even if something else has happened entirely. In this Switch node, we're going to switch based on message.payload.event.actionName. And here we're going to add the action name or ID that we gave it in the app. From here we can then choose what we want to happen. I'm going to add a couple of call service nodes and a current state node to start off with. In my first call service node, I'm going to turn on my festoon lights using the smart plug. In the second call service node, I'm going to turn on some LED lighting. We're going to add some data in here, so we're going to set the brightness to full and the RGB color to pink. Next up, we're going to use the current state node to tell if guest mode is on. If guest mode is on, we'll turn off the sitting room lights. Otherwise, we'll just leave them how they are. I'm also going to want to control some music here, so I'm going to copy some universal Sonos nodes from my scenes and input them here, changing the device to the kitchen from the dining room, because the kitchen Sonos is what my outdoor speakers are connected to. Once we're happy, we can save it, deploy it, and test it out. We can see that the widget has appeared in the widgets for the phone, and we can click it to trigger our event. I hope this video was helpful. Let me know in the comments below what you use widgets for, or what you might want to use widgets for. Also, check out my social media. And if you ever get stuck with something, feel free to drop me a message on there and I'll do my best to help you out. So there we have it, a very simple widget using the iOS companion app and Node-RED. Make sure you hit subscribe below to find out more about my smart tech and how you can build yourself the ultimate smart home.